to get your coffee? Kind of loud, isn't it? Is it okay?
Hear an echo.
Oh, I can hear an echo. My tech guy is there. All right. I'm Skip Bounce. I'm the Dean of the School of Business at the College of Coastal Georgia. Glad you all are here. 1 Million Cups is an educational program developed by the Kauffman Foundation of Kansas City. Its purpose is to engage, encourage, and support entrepreneurs and help to create an entrepreneurial network and a community of supportive mentors. We will have two entrepreneurs make six-minute presentations. We get to have one that brief, just as an aside. Which is fine, about their businesses, their nonprofits, challenges, things they've learned, problems they are having. And then after they're done, we will have you all ask them questions. Our goal is very simple, to have creative people talk to other creative people in hopes that this conversation encourages others to follow their creativity in order to enhance our local economy. At last count, there are now 120 communities who are doing the exact same things at the exact same time as we are. I'd like to welcome this month. We have some folks in Georgia who have finally caught up to us, and that is Augusta has a site that is beginning this month, as well as Cherokee, which I think means North Atlanta. So they split Atlanta. I'd like to thank some of our sponsors, Mr. Rick Townsend and Kevin Pullum of our Career Academy, who have filmed all of our films. And we don't have a student today because they still are not in school, but they all come film really well, and when you ask them what they do, they just say, I'm in media, whatever that means. And of course, we cannot thank our gracious host, Susan Bates of Tipsy. And while I'm someone who probably does not say Facebook too often, I probably call it Snapface and things like that, I would like to thank all those people here who like us and do all those things. From what I can tell, over 1,500 people were informed of what we are doing today because you like us and pass us along. And I just want to thank you all for that because it's great support. I'd also like to introduce a guest we have, and that is Dr. Meg Amstutz, who is the new college president. And I'd just like to ask her to come forward and just say a few words.
Thank you, Skip. Again, my name is Meg Amstutz, and I was really honored to be called to serve as interim president here at the College of Coastal Georgia. And my first thing I'd like to do today is simply to thank Skip Mounce for his leadership with this program. He has talked about it with me from the very first time we talked, I believe, on the telephone when I was first named. We had a chance to talk, and he was telling me about the wonderful things that are happening here in this area, and he mentioned Million Cups and the good energy that's been generated. I've already had a number of you say to me today, oh, there's so many things we could do, and you know, investments we can make. I sense the energy. I'm looking forward to hearing more ideas, and I just want to thank you for coming and supporting this program, because I think it's having people in the room that makes it work. So thanks very much, and I look forward to hearing the speakers.
If you're not on a mailing list for us and you'd like to be, there is a sign-up pad on the bar. There's also a tip jar for the host. Or if you want to leave a business card in the tip jar, that would be fine as well. Do we have any new people? This is your first time today? Great, great. Glad you could come. For all those who are not new, please welcome and don't take their wallets during break. We'll have a presentation and we'll take a break. You can refresh your coffee, network, do all the things that you do so well. And then we'll have our second presenter. But our goal is just to network. This is, you know, this is great. I go to all the other cities and look at their videos if they have them. And there are cities that are doing monthly versions that have like 5 people show up. This is really great. This is really great. Thank you very, very much. So our first presenter is Lena Barino of Simon Says. So.
My name is Lena Barino. I'm a web designer and graphic designer. I moved to St. Simon's Island a couple years ago with my family. My daughter was 3 years old at the time, and I was expecting my second baby. I worked from home, and I was very lonely. I was always looking for family-friendly activities to do with my girls, to meet new people and connect with my new community. Little by little, I discovered the wonders of living in the Golden Isles. It is a very small community, as you might know, but there are a lot of events happening all the time. We have fundraisers, we have music festivals, we have food festivals, we have dance classes at Christina's, we have yoga classes, we have pottery classes, networking events. You name it, the Golden Isles is the perfect place to raise a family and have fun. Wouldn't you agree?
Yes.
So I wanted to go to all those events, and I wanted to take my kids to those wonderful classes. Soon I found myself liking every Facebook page I could and checking different websites online, trying to plan my family day with my girls and my family time. It was frustrating and time consuming. All events were scattered around the internet. I talked to my friends and neighbors, and we were all having the same problem. No matter how hard we tried to keep up with the latest news, we always felt we were missing out on a great event. For that reason, I decided to solve the problem, and I created Simon Says. Simon Says is an online calendar and weekly newsletter that has every family-friendly event in the Golden Isles. Simon Says is an online state-of-the-art website where business owners like you are posting their events, and moms like me are planning their family time. And I am here today because my biggest struggle has been the lack of exposure. I need to get as many subscribers as I can to be able to offer a valuable advertising options to business owners. So now, I would like to hear your ideas. Thank you so much for having me.
If you have any questions, comments, I'll bring a mic to you so we can record them. Well, are there other alternatives to what you are offering on your website, and do you sell advertising?
You're asking me if there are advertising options? Yes, I have plenty of space for advertising, not only on the website, but in the newsletter that I send out every week. I can show you
real quick. So this is the home page. But then, I guess internet's slow. There it is. So I have that banner. And these are the events. So far this month, I have 55 plus events, 55 and counting, because every day I add more events.
So when you click on those events, you have more advertising space. I get reports of how many people are checking those events, how many people are clicking on them. And not only that, but this is great because moms nowadays, we have online calendars, we have Google accounts, and we want to be very organized. The paper calendar is gone. So you can easily click and add your events and share it with your Facebook friends and Google, add to your Google Calendar. It also shows you a map. If you don't know where the event is, it'll give you a Google map. And on the newsletter, I have as many as advertising space you want. I can create banners. As I mentioned, I'm a web designer and graphic designer, so everything, I do everything myself. And for that reason, I can also add good value to business owners like you who wanted to participate and share your services to families. I can create the ad for you, so that's cost effective. I'll be just charging for the space, but I need to get more subscribers.
Hi, I'm Brooke Roberts. That sounds amazing. That sounds really, really good.
Thank you.
I'm a local photographer, and I was just wondering, so you obviously mentioned you're using Facebook, but what other social platforms are you using, and kind of how are you kind of integrating those into your marketing plan?
Instagram. Okay. Instagram is big. Every time I post something, not only I get more followers and subscribers with Instagram, but I get testimonials. Yesterday, I shared information about a story time at Fort Federica. Believe it or not, they have amazing events for families, but no one knows about it. And so I shared information for this story time, and a lady in the afternoon sent me a message through Instagram. And she was thanking me for posting the event, and she had a great time with her son. And so Instagram, I'm using Instagram and Facebook to answer your question.
Are you encouraging people to use Instagram stories to kind of document their experiences and kind of link back to you and that sort of thing?
Not yet. That's a great idea. I have the Instagram link on my newsletter, and so I guess that's the only way that people know that I have Instagram. I am doing some contests every month. So right now, I am offering a $15 gift card of Sandy Bottom Bagels, and for people who can click, subscribe, and click my Facebook page and subscribe, and I have that on Instagram. So I've been doing some promotions, but I still need support from people like you that want to donate coffee or a free class. For a family, and we can, I don't know, make a contest or do something and create a story so people can post and share on Instagram.
I had a question about on your website, you've got things sort of categorized by date. Have you thought about cross-referencing by category, like kids events and business events, so that if you just wanted to isolate events in those categories, you could easily do it?
Yes, you can. You can find, right here I can show you filters. So yes, you can look events for the date of the event. You can even search for pricing. I have different categories. Let me show you. It's adult classes, community events, fundraisers, kids classes. So I do have those tools. Like the website is as complete as it can get. I need people visiting the website, sharing information, adding information. It's free. If you as a business owner are offering free meals on Tuesdays for families, feel free. Just go there. There's a click on the top bar to add your information for free. I'll be sharing it to everybody, to all my subscribers. Yes, sir.
Have you reached out to any of the small business organizations there, or like the chamber, to try to, for the networking piece, the second part, have you thought about trying to partner, and you can do it at minimum cost, with some of your local schools like PTAs or partner education, because all of a sudden, especially elementary schools, middle schools, you can branch out to 500 parents per school all of a sudden that know about you, and a lot of those are part of businesses as well or whatever else, but and that's at a minimum cost of kind of getting that word out.
I haven't. That's a great idea. I never occurred to me that I can actually make
information, and you can really do it at minimum cost and to support them. Even I'm at a college career academy, you can jump on board or something like that. I mean, it's just established relationships with the local schools where you go in and talk with the people, find out who you can contact with the PTA there or different people. Yeah, that's just kind of contacting them. I can tell you more.
Yes, I would love to hear more. Thank you very much. Yes, Skip?
I just want to say that, like Lena, I shared her frustration as the mother of a very active 7-year-old boy. When I moved back to St. Simons about 3.5 years ago, I tried so hard to find activities for my son to do on the weekend because he is not a standstill kind of kid. And it was so frustrating. And working full-time, I didn't have the time to go and comb through all of the different websites. And so I just want to commend you, Lena, on what you've done, because like we all know that there's a class at Michael's on Saturdays and a class at Home Depot, but nobody gathers that up, and I forget routinely. And I was going to say, I am sure that there are opportunities at the elementary schools as well to put, you know, sometimes like during fall festival when they do sort of their Halloween carnival, I think they'll even let you like stuff a flyer in bags, and sometimes they have bulletin boards that you can put something up in the school or talk to the teachers. So I do think there are definitely opportunities that way.
Thank you. Yes.
Churches, Way Radio, they have a calendar of events that, and I'm sure you can contact them as well.
Way
Radio, they're like
Way Radio, yes, okay.
Right next door. You know, and they have a lot of free options for families on events and carnivals. And
thank you. And I've never thought about radio, but that's a great resource. Now, I've always talked about, and I would like to get a strategic introduction, if possible, to a journalist or somebody who wants to write about it. Because there's still people reading the newspapers. And I think this project will affect our entire community and will make our lives so much better, I promise. So if you have any strategic introduction, I'd love to. Yes, Christina, you do?
Well, you've got to be in contact, and I'll be happy to introduce you to Mary Starr.
Mary Starr has been with the Brunswick News for years and in our community for years and years, and they're always looking for stories to write about, and they do a wonderful job of being a friend and promoting your business through storytelling. And Mary just has been promoted from the Brunswick News to be over only the Postal Illustrated, so that is her focus, and that's free advertisement for you, and detailed stories about your business, and she'll love you.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
If I could just mention one thing, we are in the semi-modern era here. We are live streaming to Facebook on an iPhone. So, please don't say I. Say Simon Says as many times as you can, because you've only said it twice. So please, Simon Says.
Yes. Okay, good.
Hi. I think you have a great concept, and I'm actually trying to pull it up right now. So two questions.
Yes.
I'm having difficulty finding you.
Yeah.
What's the URL of the website, and what have you done as far as search engine optimization?
Okay, so it's Simon-Says with a Z at the end .com. I know, a bit complicated, but SimonSays.com was taken. it's Simon-Says with a Z at the end.com. It is a slow, probably because of internet connection. My loading time right now is at 1 second on desktop computers and 4 seconds on mobile phones. Search engine optimization, yes, I want to do it. Now, here's the thing. I know there's a different monster, and it costs a lot of money, and it takes a lot of time to build. So now I'm doing what I can possibly can and afford, which is boots on the ground, outside, shaking hands, networking. And what better way to promote Simon Says than word of mouth? So yes, I'm interested, but I know I need a budget for that.
I have two questions for you.
Yes.
So you mentioned specifically children. Is this aimed specifically at family and children events, or do you have kind of adult events underneath there as well?
I could add adult events, but I wanted to target old families. We have young families in the island, and we all need this. I just wanted to keep it as a family-oriented tool. Yeah.
I asked specifically because there's so many live music events in the Golden Mouse, things that really people get into and they follow.
Yeah.
And some of them are kid-friendly and some are not.
Yes.
And there's a lot of vibe, particularly down here at Tipsy's, in the village. You know, once the Jekyll Island Club opens up Latitudes again, there'll be another live music event area. There's a lot of things like that, and I know our family, we hunt those down specifically because it's so much fun to sit outside and listen to live music. So I wonder if you could do like a whole section on that and then do a competition on Instagram with the Instagram stories, getting people to send you a story of what their favorite moment was from the live music. Everybody's going to follow that, you know, and people love to have competitions where they make their own little stories. Everybody's visually orientated these days.
That is a great idea. I do post outdoor concerts and festivals. I do as long as it's family friendly. Mm-hmm. When I get information from all those events, I'm always checking. Sometimes they're not mentioning children. So I just stay away from those because
sure.
I don't want to promote an event that you cannot take your kids. Right? I can't do that. But yes, I have outdoor concerts, and there are a couple of concerts happening. One here this Sunday at Mary Ross, and there's one in St. Simons. That was part of my newsletter this week. And I get, so far, it's the most, the events are being clicked on most of the time. So yes, you're right. It has a lot of people are interested in music, yes.
Yeah, that's amazing. So one simple little thing that you can do for SEO optimization that a lot of people overlook is anytime you put an image on your website, make sure that you name it. So when you go in there and there's like a JPEG number, make sure you put a specific name on that JPEG and you change the name. So you would put in there like a descriptive word, like Golden Isles Events.
Yeah.
And you can do Golden hyphen Isles hyphen Events. You can put, you know, a little phrase in there. It needs to be small because Google won't like it if you go too crazy.
Okay.
But when Google looks at images, it can't see what's in the photograph. So if you put a description underneath there, when you then go back and attach it to your website, when the Google snakes go out, they're going to find your image. They're going to know how to categorize it. And it's going to put you higher up on the SEO optimization. It's a really simple, easy thing to do, and it really will make a difference.
I will do that. Thank you very much.
And we also have our first question from a live stream watcher.
Oh, wow, okay. What's your question, watcher?
Melissa Trussell asked, how does your two differ from the festivals and events calendar on goldenisles.com?
On where?
Goldenisles.com.
That's convention and visitor website.
That's what I'm saying?
The convention and visitors.
Yes. So I am different because I only have family-friendly activities. On the other hand, the Golden Isles calendar has all events. And as a mom, I don't want to see all events. I want to see every event that is related to my kids and family and classes. They don't list any classes. They don't list Christina's classes or the pottery, the Color Me Happy classes. They list more general to general public events. That's my biggest difference. Yes.
You can take one more question.
Yes.
Mine necessarily isn't a question as much as it is a comment. I think you're cutting off a huge base of eyeballs on your website by limiting it to just families, like we've said. I don't have little ones, and just looking at the general age of the people in this room, probably don't have little ones. And our community has a older population. I mean, that's people come here and retire. So you want more eyeballs on your website. You might want to expand that because as much as you're a family, the general population is older, and don't discount those of us who read the newspaper and have paper calendars, because that's who we are.
Yes.
That's who we are, and that's just what works for us. So you're cutting off your base. I'm just commenting.
Yes,
that.
Yes,
yes.
Thank you.
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 comment.
Thank you for your comment. I understand, and I'm not pushing anybody away. Actually, some of the events I post and I like to post, like for example, did you know the newsletter has an Alzheimer's support group? That's, you know, did you know that they have adult coloring classes? I post those events. I just don't want to post events like the comedy club, you know? I want to post events that we all benefit from it. I'm not saying, you know, don't go there because you don't have any children. I'm just saying I'm being selective on the events I post and I share.
Okay, one more question.
Yes.
And I just wanted to say that for families like mine,
yeah.
I don't have kids, but I'm going to family-friendly events. That's what I'm looking for.
Okay, so subscribe.
I just did now. And
thank
I'm
you.
Sending Mary Starr a message right now about you. If you will come back and give me your phone number, contact information real quick.
Yes, sir, thank
I'll
you.
I'll send that right to her.
And just really quick, she is wonderful, and she just got her, tell them what happened.
Oh, okay, so after 15 years, I finally got my American citizenship. Thank you, Tina. That is a long story for another day, but I can tell you, and it's a very long story, but
well,
I can tell you, I'm so proud, thank you.
Thank you very much, and there's always a little bit of corporate swag underneath. So let's take a break, fill up your coffee, and we'll have another presenter shortly. Thank you.